All right, so this is another edition of the bioscience class, and today we bring to you the first lesson in biochemistry, structures and function, which we are going to talk about homogenization and self-fractionation. Okay, so this video, what we are going to cover is what really homogenization and self-fractionation of a cell really means and the processes involved in this process. Okay, so let's start. Usually a cell consists of different subcellular fractions. These are called what, organelles. And you see, normally the cell, we have many organelles, and these organelles are perform the various functions, and these organelles too can be identified or separated from the whole cell by this process called cell fractionation. Now, after this, we've done this cell fractionation, we'll dive into marker enzymes, and we'll see how these marker enzymes are able to help to identify the presence or the absence of a particular organelle in this process. So when we talk about self-fractionation usually means breaking up a cell, and when we say breaking up, that means we are distracting the cell to make a tissue of it so that we can send it to, you know, centrifugation to separate them into their various forms. So we break up the cell and we separate, then make suspension of the cell constituent in an isotonic medium. Okay, so the underlying word here is isotonic medium. Now let's talk about this isotonic medium. So usually why we require an isotonic medium in cell fractionation when breaking up a cell is that this isotonic solution helps the solution to be at a constant what, pH. Okay, so the isotonic medium means it is having the same concentration, that's the cell has the same concentration of what, as a solution. Okay, so there will be at the same concentration gradient, so there is not going to be any osmosis, which can further what, prevent the cell for further studies. All right, so this isotonic medium helps to study their structure and their chemical composition very effectively. Okay, so that's what the isotonic medium usually means. All right, okay. So let's dive into cell fractionation and let's see what processes, what steps usually involves in this cell fractionation. Okay, all right, so the first process in cell fractionation is called what, extraction. All right, so the first step in cell fractionation is the extraction. Now this extraction is where the most of the processes are involved. Okay, so before any subcellular structure can be isolated, the first need to be extracted from the cell. Okay, so let's say we have an onion cell and we want to know what organelles, or we have as any cell that we want to study, and we want to, let's say, study the organelles involved in that particular cell. The first step we have to do is to extract. All right, we have to break open the cell so that we can further process it through the following step, the other step that we are going to talk about. All right, so after the extraction, now they are then extracted in mild condition, for example appropriate pH condition and suitable environmental temperature. Now the reason why we have to get an appropriate pH is that we see usually the organelles, they have particular pH that they can be separated, and any pH that is high or below can affect the end results and can help denature the enzymes in that particular organelle. So when the enzymes in that particular organelles are denatured, then that means we cannot be able to identify our marker enzymes in order to determine whether this particular organelle is present or not. Okay, all right, and a suitable temperature. Now this suitable temperature helps to prevent the enzymes from being what denatured. Okay, so when the temperature is so high, the enzymes could be denatured and our end result is not going to be what we are looking for. So this temperature is on in order to maintain the biological activities of these organelles to prevent them from being what denatured. Okay, all right, so let's go to the next step involved in the cell fractionation. All right, so let's talk details into about the process of extraction. So that's the first steps in cell fractionation, okay, and homogenization. So the tissue to be studied is cut into smaller pieces and they are placed on an ice cold and a buffer solution. So as I said earlier, the reason why we put it on an ice cold, okay, is to stop the enzyme activity. So the organelles, they have particular enzymes. They have let's say a specific enzyme that each contains. Okay, so each enzyme is exclusive. All right, so in order to prevent this enzyme from reacting and being denatured at the end, we have to place them on an ice cold so that the enzymatic activity will slow down or will stop. Okay, so the isotonic solution, as I said earlier, they have the same concentration and water potential as a cytoplasm to prevent osmosis, which can damage the organelles and affect our end results. Okay, so this buffer also keeps the pH constant, so proteins are not being denatured, as I said earlier. So this is the process that is involved in the first step called what, extraction. Okay, so let's talk about the next step and what it really entails. So the second step after we've extracted our cell, the next step is to grind into smaller pieces using a homogenizer to release the organelles from the cell. So usually it is done by grinding, sonication, or high pressure. So the homogenizer is used to break open the cells. That means we are extracting the cell and making what, a tissue of it, so that we can subject it to centrifugation in order to identify the specific organelles present. So we can do it by grinding, or let's say blending it with a sonicator or high pressure, so that it can form a solution. So the homogenate or the lysate, now this is the tissue that we get. So the solution that we get after homogenizing the cell is called what, a homogenate or cell lysate. Okay, so now this is filtered to remove any complete cells and larger debris such as cell wall and cell membrane, which can affect the results we are looking for. Okay, all right, so let's talk about the third steps involved in this process. So the third step involved in this process is called the pellet is removed, okay, and the supernatant remaining is respun at a faster speed. Okay, so that means after the second process, that means the cell fractionation, the homogenization is complete. So we now continue with homogenization. All right, that's the process that goes through is ultra centrifugation, that centrifugation process. So after we've done the homogenization, now the pellet is removed. So after we've subjected it to centrifugation, the pellet is removed. All right, and the supernatant, so the pellet is the bottom portion of the test tube after we've centrifuged it, okay? And the supernatant is the upper portion of the in the test tube after we've centrifuged it. So this pellet is at the bottom, it settles at the bottom. And this also, it depends on the size of the organelle. So larger sizes sediments faster. So the larger size will settle at the bottom and the lighter ones will be at the upper. So the lighter ones are called supernatant and they are re-centrifuged so that we can identify completely the organelles that are present. Okay, all right. So the fourth process, the process is repeated at higher speeds so that, you know, each and every organelle has the speed, that the revolution per minute, that we can separate the organelles completely. So after each centrifugation, we re-subject the supernatant for another centrifugation till we completely identify any organelle present in that particular cell. Alright, so let's continue. So this is the simplified steps for homogenization and self-fractionation. So we have this image here and it is describing the whole process in a simplified form. Okay, so now when you come here, the first process is tissue extraction. Okay, so now this tissue extraction is where we extract the cell, okay, the cell, the tissue component from the cell, so that we can further subject it to homogenization. All right, so this homogenization is pictured here, and when you come here, we have a blender here, so we are blending the whole cell so that we will get a tissue from it. After that, we transfer into a test tube. Okay, all right, so the solution that we got after homogenization is called a homogenate or a cell lysate. All right, so when you come here, the third process is differential centrifugation. Now this, after we've gotten the homogenate, you see the next step is differential centrifugation. So we further subject it to differential centrifugation. Now this is first centrifuge with 60 minutes, okay, so that the organelle present, the larger ones, will settle at the bottom. Then we will get a pellet and a supernatant. So we will study further again and let's see what the process is all about. Okay, so we have an important information. So the organelle sizes are similar in all cells, so we can predict when they will form a pellet. Okay, so we know the size of each organelle and we know their structure, so we can use that to predict the organelles that are going to, let's say, be present at the end of the first centrifugation. All right, since the whole process involves centrifugation at different speeds, it is called differential centrifugation. So each cells have different sizes and mass, so this is called what, differential centrifugation. So let's come to this image here and let's see if we can get more and clear understanding of what we are talking of. So this is the first process. We filter our homogenate to remove clumps of unbroken cells and connective tissues. Okay, all right, so these at the bottom are the clumps and the larger cells that can't be subjected to centrifugation. So we make sure we remove everything before we further subject it to centrifugation. So after this centrifugation process, what we have here is the filtered homogenate. So the filtered homogenate is subjected to centrifugation. All right, okay, now this is done in 10 minutes with 600 gravity. All right, 600 gravitational force. So we centrifuged it and what we got at the top here is called supernatant. What we got at the bottom here is called pellet. So as we can see from the first centrifugation, we can clearly see that nucleus is present at the first centrifugation. So after we've gotten the nucleus, all right, we separate it and we transfer the supernatant onto another test tube so that we can re-centrifuge it. Okay, so what we can usually predict to see whether this nuclei is really present is using their marker enzymes to identify them. So, all right, so we'll talk about marker enzymes in the next video, and we will describe each every organelles and their their marker enzymes. All right, so then let's talk about the next step. We recentrifuge it at 15,000 gravitational force in 5 minutes, and after that we can see that we've gotten mitochondria, chloroplast, lysosomes and peroxisomes. So now you see we have all these organelles here, so they have the same sizes, that mean. So in order to determine whether the specific one we are looking for is here, we have to stick to the marker enzymes and test it, so if everything is present. So the next step, we recentrifuge our supernatant, and what we got here is plasma membrane, microsomal fractions, and etc. So further centrifugation, we get ribosomal subunit and small polyribosomes. All right, so we pour out our last centrifugation. Then you see everything is centrifuged. There is no enzyme present at this site. We have soluble portion of a cytoplasm called what? The cytosol. Okay, so let's move to the next slide. So that's the end of the slides. So we hope to continue with your marker enzymes on our next presentation, and do well to subscribe to this channel and like it and press the bell to receive any notification that comes. Have a nice day and have a wonderful day. Thank you very much. Bye.